Hello everyone, my name is Palms to Mayoi. I'm back for another part of Palms to Mayoi stream number 90. Chill out, Palms to Mayoi number 80 birthday stream. Like I said, it's going to be part 6. Well, I didn't say that. I said it was going to be another part. It's going to be part 6. For some reason, the last one just cut off. I don't know why it did. But anyways, I was showing you my Pokemon cards. Let me just show you where I left off in the video where it showed last. So I was pretty much on the... It was like right before the electric types. Yeah, it was like here it was. So anyways, I was just showing you that stuff, but then it freaking cut off. So anyways, and then literally after that, I was just gonna say that I was like putting my stuff away, and then I was gonna show you like my some of my other stuff, like my video games and all that. Yeah, that was literally it. So, so anyway, I was literally just putting my Kindle down, and then just like I saw that it just stopped recording for some reason. I don't know why, but it just did. I'm not sure, like I said, why that happened, but it just decided to. So yeah. Anyways, so I'm gonna go ahead and put that stuff back. I'm going to go ahead and actually, real quick, I'm just going to be adding on an extra 10 minutes. Because, like, how long that took for me to get back online and stuff like that. So, yeah. Alright, just making sure all that's good. Okay, well, anyways, I'm going to be putting my stuff back. So, I'm going to make sure I put everything back correctly. Oh, that's how I had it. Hold on a second. And then, what else did I have? Like this. Oh, that's how I usually have it. I don't have the folder on the bottom. Hold on. I usually have that on the top. I usually use that a lot. Yeah, hold on a second. That's how I usually have that. Thank you. we go. I forgot the duct tape. Hold on. Yeah, that's something that was in there. I just had it all the way along there. It rolled off. I can go right here. That's fine. Anyways, let me put my belt back. And I'll go ahead and bring over the video games and stuff like that. Alright, so anyways, I guess I'll start with the Wii stuff. Well, there's also GameCube. You can play GameCube games on the basic Wii. But anyways, I have all these games. They take out the disc ones that don't have cases. It's just literally stuffed in this one little disc case, so. Anyways, yeah, I don't even know if a lot of these work. I think a lot of them do, but not all of them, I'm pretty sure. But anyways, Mario Tennis for the GameCube, Nicktoons Unite for the GameCube, Super Monkey Ball Adventure for the GameCube, Pac-Man World 3 for the GameCube, yeah, Wario World for the GameCube, Super Monkey Ball 2 for the GameCube, and then Wii Sports for the Wii. Alright, we're going to go ahead and put all those back in the case. There you go, Need for Speed Most Wanted, Need for Speed Hot Pursuit 2, Naruto 2 Clash of Ninja, at least for GameCube by the way, all of these I'm about to say, Luigi's Mansion, Mario Kart Double Dash, Super Mario Sunshine, Pac-Man World 2, Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy, and Paper Mario 1000 Year Door. Alright, so then the
games out of the way for the Wii, I'll actually show you the Wii console themselves. So, this recently, this is a working Wii remote. There's going to be two in there that don't work, because I've tried them, and they just are so glitchy, or just won't turn on at all. But this is the one I got from my sister's boyfriend. It works, and I was borrowing it for a while, and then he just said I can keep it, so yeah. So, pretty cool. I love the color black as well, so it's a win-win. And then I have all these Wii nunchucks. The whole reason why I mainly wanted the Wii, just the basic Nintendo Wii, is because you can play GameCube games on them, and also play, you know, the Wii games. One of the main ones why you would want the nunchucks is for the game series Super Mario Galaxy, because you need it to actually be able to move. And then with like the Wii Remote, you use A to jump and shake it to be able to do the spin. And yeah, that's the reason why. But so yeah, three of these, three nunchucks, that's awesome. And then these, like I said, these ones are like glitched or just won't turn on. So yeah, the back cover for this can be used for that black Wii Remote if you actually are going to use it. Because for now, I don't actually use the batteries for like playing games. I just pretty much just like direct it to the game that I want, that I can use this controller on, the GameCube controller, because you can plug it in on the top. I'll show you the actual Wii consoles themselves very soon. But yeah, like I would plug in the GameCube controller, and whatever game I can play with that, I'd pretty much direct it with the Wii Remote, because you need the Wii Remote to actually be able to go through the Wii, because otherwise you can't actually use the Wii. You need to actually navigate through it. So then you can pretty much turn off the Wii Remote to save batteries after you've gotten the game. You can use the GameCube controller. So yeah. And then the actual cords and stuff, this would be the hookup for the TV. You plug this into the Wii, and you like plug this to the TV, the three. You need like an older TV for that, for those like cord plug-in things. And then the sensor bar. This is very important, because you actually need it to be able to point the Wii to direct it as like a cursor on it. So without it, you literally can't use the Wii Remote on that Wii. And then this would be thing you plug into an electrical outlet and plug into the Wii for actually to be able to power it. And then these are like extra cords that are like that, but they're just, I have them just in case for some reason if I don't want to use them eventually. Yeah, but they're pretty much just the same exact uses. It's just like a bunch of clumped up stuff. So let me just separately get them out of there, just so they're not really clumped up and everything. Yeah. Anyway, now the two Wii consoles that I have. So I have two of them for specific reasons. So, alright, so here it is. So the one with, let me get like a better view. The one with this open, this is the one that I'm eventually going to hack. Mainly for recording reasons, okay? To record the inside. Eventually when I get like a smartphone, I can fit on my tripod, that I will be showing you the tripod soon. For now, I don't have anything like that, so if I'm ever able to hack this Wii, I need more SD cards to like make sure the installation for the hacked program doesn't freeze, because it's been doing that with the two that I have. So anyway, this will be the one. I bought this one personally for $10, crazy enough, and it works well, it works amazing. It's just, I'm using this, I'm going to use this as like hacked Wii. So that's why I have it like this, so that I know it's going to be the Wii that I'm going to hack. So pretty much these top parts right here, this is where the GameCube controllers go for like the plugging in. And these two things right here, these little ports, I don't even know if you can see it that well. Okay, you can see it better like that. See, like these are the GameCube holes. And these are for the GameCube memory cards, because you need actually those to save your GameCube games, because it won't save on an SD card the GameCube memories. You can play GameCube games on there fine without the memory card. It's just whenever you turn off the Wii or just exit the game, all the stuff you did would be lost. So yeah. And for like plugging in, the sensor bar would be for the red, and then this one would be for the plug-in to the TV, and this would be the power output ones.
Yeah.
And then, this would be, of course, the disc, where you put the disc in. This would be the SD card spot, and this would be, it even says it, it's like, the top one is the power, and this one's the reset, and this red button is like, sync up Wii remotes, and then this is to eject. So yeah, you know the basic buttons. And this one I've had, it's just been in the house because I gave to whoever in this house, and then it's been passed on through them and stuff. But it still is alive and well. So this has, like, pretty much all the games that I bought on it back in the day. And it even has... What else does it have? This is the one I'm not going to have. This is the one I'm going to be keeping as it is itself. It has a whole bunch of games. Eventually, like I said, when I actually do the whole tripod thing, I'll be showing you all the games that are on there. But there's a lot of them, like, downloaded inside. They're downloaded on the SD card because the actual Wii memory, you need to, like, keep that as empty as you can so that you can have... so that you can actually have the save data on there saved for the WiiWare games and just the Wii games in general. And then the SD card, you can download the games on there. So, yeah. So, anyway, those are pretty much my Wii consoles. So I'm going to go ahead and put that away. And then I'll go ahead and show you the tripod next. Actually, no, I'm going to show you the DS next. There's not that much, because you already know about my basic DS, but I'll show you it anyways. Let me just sort stuff out. It's funny how good of a box this is, because it's literally the box I got for when I bought the Wii at that yard sale that's, like, not too far away from where I'm living in this house. Like, it's not too far along the street. They literally gave me this as this box, and it actually turned out to be such a perfect size box, because it just fit all this stuff in here. It's so crazy. Yeah. Yeah, the whole reason why it was just, like, pretty much since no one else had, like, one of these, like, a sensor bar, they weren't actually able to use the Wii anyway, so I pretty much was just given the first Wii that was originally mine, but then, like I said, it was passed around the family, so it was just whoever wants to play it. But now this is actually, like, mine, so, yeah, I was able to do all that editing and stuff like that I wanted to on the Wii, so it's actually mine, and, yeah, but anyways... Alright, I'm gonna go put this away, and I'll be back. The whole box, I mean. Okay. So anyways, Yeah, I'll show you the cases and then the actual games themselves for the DS. Yeah, so let me just sort that out real quick. Literally just gonna take a few seconds. Alright, so games that I had back then for the cases was including this one, but I actually have the game Mario & Luigi Bowser's Inside Story. It's not the original game I got with this case like years ago. I think it was like 2013. But then these games, like this one specifically, I'm gonna get just for multiplayer Mario Party DS. And then these games, the Pokemon games, Pokemon Black 2 and White 2. Oh, let me give you a better view of that. But yeah, they don't actually have the games in them for now. For now, eventually I will get the games, though. I'll have them for now. And then this one, I actually have the game in there. And I got Pokemon Soul Silver, Pokemon Y, Pokemon Ultra Sun, Pokemon Omega Ruby, and Pokemon Moon. So yeah, anyways. And I'll show you the DS itself as well. Let me just sort this stuff out. Can put this like this. So, DS, you've seen it plenty of times if you watched my streams. It's literally the same exact DS. Same stuff. Yeah, same stuff. So, anyways. And then the computer stuff, there's not that much. You already saw the cord in the computer itself. But this is the mouse pad I use for whenever I want to use this mouse. And then the flash drive I literally use like all the time for like putting videos on there. And then when I'm done uploading them, I delete them off. And then files for like my computer's getting too full, which it seems like it's doing that lately. Or it's just getting too full and it says it's out of disk space. And then yeah, I'm just keeping that temporarily on the flash drive. So there's that. I'm just gonna put that away. And then I'll go ahead and show you all the final thing, the tripod. So yeah, tripod, this is amazing. For now, like I said, I won't be able to use it, but I'll have a device that's small enough to actually fit in it. So yeah, so anyways, let me go ahead and unpack that. It's gonna be right here. See the box and everything. That's such a cool case as well. This is the box and the actual packaging is right here. So it's so cool, like this packaging. It literally, you can hold it like a strap and have it like a quilt or something. Or not a quilt, an arrow quiver or something like that. It's literally what it's gonna be used for. But anyways, I'm gonna unzip this thing. Go ahead and take the stuff out, being the main tripod, of course. And I'll try to put the pieces together. Let me just actually open this thing up. See? Pretty crazy. I'll show you the whole thing, like I'll take the camera out when I undo this, but yeah, let me just go ahead and like max it out the most that I can. Just get that all good. So you can go up. Alright. Pretty incredible. Let me get out the parts for it. Alright. And then I'll get the top part screwed on. It's literally just like this with my hand. It's not even that tough. think it's... Oh, no, it's on this. Hold on. Let me stand up real quick. Just I'm trying to see. I think it's literally just do this. Oh, you pull like that. That's why I was like, why is it not? Why is it not doing that? Anyways, I don't think you take this piece out. Maybe you do. I don't think you do though. Oh no, you don't. You actually. Yeah, not supposed to come out. Oops. That's not supposed to do that. There we go. And this part would be the thing you screw in. Gotta get it all screwed in. And you can all see the masterpiece that I will eventually use whenever I actually have a device small enough to use it. So anyways, yeah.
Lift this thing up now. Alright, so this is the master tripod. Literally I got it at Walmart for $32. Well, $31.90, but anyways, this thing right here. This is what you use to hold your camera with. It can only go so tall. Like, here, let me try to... Yeah, this is like for when you want to move it like this or something, and you can lock it. But literally, my Kindle is just small enough to where, like, it's not going to let me... Here, I'll try to do the max. I can, like, do that. Like, it won't go higher than that. I tried maxing it out, and my Kindle is just big enough to where it won't fit in there. So I don't have anything else. It's literally... This is amazing tripod just waiting in my closet to be used one day. And just, it freaking, I can't use it right now, but it's amazing though. It's quite amazing. But yeah, anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and put all that stuff back. I guess I'm not that tired now, so I can just, I guess I can go ahead and just go back to playing Pokemon Ultra Sun. Cause yeah, I just like was running out of stuff to show you, so. Yeah, but anyways, I'm gonna put this just away. Yeah, I hope you all enjoyed that whole tour thing. I was originally going to make it a highlight, but no, this is like way too freaking long of a thing to make a highlight, so nope, not doing that. I'll just be, you know, this stream, and then the last stream, because like, in the beginning it was, a lot was about that, but, yeah, no. Well, let me make sure this is all sorted out. Is this going to close or is it going to be annoying? No, it's going to close. Okay, good, good. Good, good. Alright, anyways. Yeah, I'll put this away. Unscrew this handle. Believe it or not, that's the piece where you gotta, like, unscrew. So literally, you don't use any of the tools. You just, like, unscrew with your hand. It's like a... This handle, I mean, see. Anyways, and then slowly get this back down. Well, I'm an idiot. I was doing it the wrong way. I was like, why is it making so much noise? It's literally the other way. It's like a pencil sharpener. You ever seen those? It's cool, like a manual one. And then, yeah. That's what I was doing. I was like, why the heck are you doing that? That's how it is, so anyways. Oh, this thing tightens, yeah, this thing tightens the whole thing so it doesn't go up and down. And then you put this back, like this, and it closes up. And then we get the magical quiver of tri-bodiness, and yeah. Then there, tripod. I don't want to see you again until I actually am able to use you, okay? You'll just be in my closet. Just, oh my god. Hold on, let me actually fully unzip this thing. There we go. Jeez. Okay. Get in there.
Get the heck in there. There we go. Jeez. Alright. Then I actually gotta get those other little parts as well in there. Like the handle. And then the bag of pieces. Oh, is it stuck? I think it's just... Yeah, no, she's being weird. Okay, it's all good. Get the box. Alright. I will go ahead and be back. I'm literally going to be like a minute long at the very most. I'm just going to put this in my closet. Just going to put the box back on. Well, there we go. I'll be back. See, I told you it wasn't even going to be a minute long. Alright. So anyway, I'm going to set that stuff back up. Go ahead and get my charger back. It's plugged in. My headset back on. Set all this back up. Alright. Alright. Now let me actually set this up a lot better. Oh, the tent's unzipped. Whatever. That's fine. Alright, so... back to Pokemon Ultra Sun. If I feel like I'm gonna fall asleep again, well... I don't know. I'll just not play video games. I'll just chill out. Just, like... do other stuff. I don't know. What I just want is, like, play video games. I'm able to, unless I feel sleepy, like you said, then I'll do something else. But for now, gonna be in Ultra Sun, Pokemon Ultra Sun, into trying to get that Salazzle from the SOS call from the Salandits. So, yeah. Yeah, definitely I do not feel as tired as I was before, so that's really good. That was mission complete. Because literally I felt like I was going to pass out when I last played video games. Yeah, I was just feeling so tired. Now I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. Persian's about to level up. One more battle, and he is... yeah. Oh, what? Persian literally now is one more battle. I thought that battle was going to do it. Apparently not. We'll land it. Maybe this land it will be the one to summon the Salazzle. That'd be great. Oh, but yeah, last time, every time Persian would be like killing these. So I'm going to switch out to Grimer. So I just kept doing that when I was feeling all tired. I just kept thinking that Persian might not kill the next one, but he kept killing every single one. It was so bad. I killed like four of them, I think. Persian was just like one-shotting them, so yeah. Okay, Grimer's got this. One more acid spray. Okay, never mind, we got a critical hit. My gosh, why? Why did that happen? Alright, Persian level 33, that's nice. But geez, that's... Everything was going well until we got that critical. Alright, well... Okay, another sand... I almost called you a sand isle. You're Salandon, not a sand isle. Okay, same thing I did last time. Poison Fang and then Acid Spray. And as long as I don't get critical hits, you know, you'll live. Okay, actually, you're pretty low health right now, so I'm just going to use Minimize. Okay, good. Call him for help. Actually, call him a Salazzle. That'd be great. Okay, you didn't get any help. Alright, that's fine. I will just keep, you know, letting the turns go by until you call for help. Yeah, I don't know. If I do feel tired enough, I might just go to some AR games. Augmented reality. With the augmented reality cards, and I have those in my closet. But if I feel tired enough, like I said, I'll do that. But I might not have to. It might be just good to stay up for the next 2 hours, 10 minutes. And just do this, you know. I don't know, maybe I will be able to, maybe not. I'm not sure. It all depends. If I'm feeling like so super tired, then obviously I won't be playing this, because then I'll just feel like I'm going to fall asleep. So, or maybe I just might play another game. I don't know. Because I have... Yeah, I have The Legend of Zelda, something with the Four Swords Anniversary Edition on my 3DS, not my 3DS, the 2DS, so I have that as well if I'm feeling like super bored and tired. I'll go to something else, because sometimes just Pokemon is just super boring to me, like me just being in one spot how I am now, just training or just trying to search for something. Then it'll get boring to me, and I'll feel like all sleepy and stuff. Yeah, even when I'm just doing something else, like continuing through battling other trainers, it still gets like pretty boring to me. Just sometimes it just feels like that, and I just like don't want to continue for a while. That's like with the whole thing with the Pokemon ROMs I have on my Kindle. Like the last one I left off on was Pokemon Black One. And I just didn't feel like in the mood to like play that game because I didn't want to play Pokemon, you know, just like in my free time. So just sometimes that's like how I feel, you know. I love Pokemon and all that. It's just I times that I don't want to play, I just straight up won't. So yeah, so that's one of the things I most likely would do. Because I do have this game called Base Raiders as well, but that one's kind of weird. I have to do a lot of moving around. Augmented reality games is not that bad. It's not, how do I say? It's not so much of moving that I don't like, it's just straight up, you all won't be able to really see me that much if I'm like moving around, just like doing that kind of stuff constantly. So, yeah, it's gotta be something that you'll be able to actually see a lot of me of. Otherwise, there wouldn't be really much point. So, yeah. Yeah, at the very least, the thing I'm going to be mainly doing when I get tired in this stream, I'm going to be going ahead and try to go to that Four Swords Anniversary Edition Legend of Zelda game. Because believe it or not, you actually can't get it as that as a DSiWare unless you got it back then, because it was a free game back then. You needed to actually get it on the DSi shop, and they shut that down a long time ago. So the only way you'd be able to get something like that would be if someone else had it. So luckily, on my sister's DSi XL, she had it on there. So I pretty much just to play it safe, I transferred it over to my 3DS. Well, it's not a 3DS. It's like it has 3DS programming. It's a 2DS XL. But anyways, yeah, so pretty much I thought maybe I could just copy it over to mine. But apparently whenever you transfer it over like that to the to a 3DS or 2DS system, it pretty much just deletes it on the original device. So I think I'll be able to like switch some files around and get that game back on her DS again. But she said she pretty much doesn't really care, so I was like, okay. So I have it on here. But yeah, so anyways, what was I doing? Oh, so landed. Okay, so hopefully I do not accidentally kill this thing. Please, please no. And I would love for you to call in Salazzle. That'd be great. Because I want to finally move on. Okay, I'll just use Minimize now. You're low enough health, so I don't want to attack you anymore. And yeah, just please call in Salazzle. Please. Or you know, if you don't call in Salazzle, gladly just call in the shiny Salandit. I will gladly catch that. But, you know, I would love the Salazzle. That'd be great. So I can actually move on. So I already got the Magmar, and now it's just you giving up one of your elders, the Salazzle. So I'll just go ahead and do that. I'm waiting. This thing is just not calling in for help. What are you doing, Salandit? Can you just call him for help, please? Why? Why are you not calling for help? Why? So annoying. Literally in low yellow help. What are you doing? Why are you not calling for help? Seriously? I actually have to switch out. So that's, okay, there we go. Now you're calling for help. Thank you. Please. And didn't get help. Okay. Well, now I gotta. Anyways, what was I doing? Right, I slammed it. Okay, so I'm switching out. Switch out to Brionne. And then I'm going to go ahead and switch out the charger bug. And just keep spamming charge. That's what the whole thing is going to be. Until this thing actually calls me for help. And yeah. Oh, calling for help. Come on, get your help. And it's a normal Salazzle. Why do you do this? I literally ask for a Salazzle. Or a shiny Salazzle. Or a shiny Salazzle. That would be insane to call in a Salazzle. Oh wow, okay. I thought I was gonna definitely kill that Salandit there. That would have sucked. Well, the whole process over again. Literally, this is what I've been doing for like the whole day. I still. Thank you. Oh my god, I got a freaking critical hit. This planet died, oh my god. Why does that have to happen? Why? Times I don't want a critical hit. Jesus, man. It freaking sucks. Yeah, at least we get another slander. Please don't critical hit this. It's probably gonna critical hit. I'm betting it. Please don't. Please. Okay, thank God. Okay, jeez. It's still storming out there. It's crazy. Keep seeing flashes of light and stuff. I would have swore a few nights ago I saw some like UFOs in the sky. Like, you may think I'm like screwing around, but seriously, like when I was just outside, I'm just seeing like lights on their own and going in like formations and stuff. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. I would not be surprised. You never know these days. Creepy stuff. Like this one clip, it's from a meme or something, but it was literally like UFOs being filmed, and then there were like cops around, and this guy was like, "Y'all need to shoot that." It was so good. Oh wait, yeah, that's right. Oh crap, my grammar's about to faint. Oh, thank god. The Cubone needs a leer. She's just about to level up too, so she might level up. Maybe. Nope, one more battle. I'm gonna go heal up though, because she's literally at 5 health. Yeah, I know Rotom, I just realized. Completely forgot. Heal up. Thank you. Yeah, because I just completely forgot. Oh, man. Good thing she didn't get attacked, though. Well, I don't know. Because the Cubones, the ground type attacks, you know, it's not good for my Grimer. Not a good thing. Ground rule of 34, oh baby. Let them evolve, okay. It must be like 35, 37 or something like that. Oh, I think I'm done playing Pokemon for the rest of the stream because I'm feeling dead tired. So I'm going to Legend of Zelda Four Swords 25th Anniversary Edition. Let me go ahead and just switch the games out. I mean, the Legend of Zelda game's inside my 2DS, but I'm just saying. For me to, you know, shiny hunt the next time, so the Pokemon Y game will be in my DS, not the Pokemon Ultra Sun game. Sucks I wasn't able to get Salazzle, but at least I got Magmar. I know I could easily, you know, just wait until later in the game to do that. But if there's a chance that it could be summoned, then yeah, I'm gonna train my luck like that and do that, so yeah. Yep, that one's a pretty epic story. Alright, do this. Well, that was pretty fun. I just got done with the first world of that game. I don't have that much time until the stream is up. I'm pretty sure. Let's see. Yeah, 11:50. Okay, so I got about 15 minutes left. What I want to do. I can either play Face Raiders or AR games. One of those. I'm not really sure. I don't think I've ever really beat Face Raiders before. But then again. No, I'll just do AR games. Actually gotta go get them from my closet, the cards. Alright. I'll be back. It's literally gonna take a few seconds. Yeah, I'm just going to sit up for the rest of the time. I think I need it to be like a really lit up surface, hold on. Not bright enough, I don't know. How about I do this? Hold on. I'm gonna use my computer as the brightness and have like a text file like this open. Maybe this will work. I'm betting this is gonna work. I kinda tilt it. Yeah, I'm betting this is absolutely gonna work. Yeah, it works. Oh my god. It's so funny how I'm literally using my computer screen and like bending it and putting it at max brightness and then it works. That's so freaking funny. Let's use some classic fishing. Anyways, 10 minutes left of the stream. So yeah. Got a mackerel. Oh my god. There's this big one. What the heck did I just catch? Another mackerel? Yep. Okay then. Huge one. What is this? Red snapper? Yeah, red snapper. Nice. What is this huge one? This is a bass? Oh, a tuna. Oh my god. There's another mackerel. Yep. Oh, is this a flounder? Yeah. Okay, nice. Oh, I see the dragonfish. It's literally just a dragon. Mackerel. Hi, dragon. Fish up the dragon! Oh my gosh! Dragon! Dragon! What the? Freaking dragon! caught the dragon. Oh my god. Ooh. You're 75 points, not too bad. Too bad at all. I'll do some archery. Ni hao, Shane. I'm just playing some AR games. I've literally got like 5 minutes left of the stream until I end it, so you came in just in time. Yeah, I was just finishing up like the birthday stream. I couldn't like do the full 14 hours on Wednesday. That was my birthday. So today I finished the rest of the 11 hours in like a few minutes. I'll have finished it, and then finally it's all good. But yeah, after that I'll make sure to do, you know, like actually go to sleep. But I wanted to make sure to get that done today, so I wasn't like so I didn't have that like needed to do. I just want to get that done today. That's what I wanted to do. There is no new camera, Shane. I still am like, I haven't made any money or anything like that, so it's like, you know, I didn't get anything new, so. Alright, well. Alright, so finally, birthday stream is complete. It may have took, I think this is a 6-part, but you know, it's finally over. I finally completed that. Like I said I would, it just took a bunch of parts, so yeah, it's finally done. So expect this to be up on YouTube whenever it gets up later tonight. But anyways, yeah. I just had a stretch before I actually continue talking. anyways, yeah, so I've been your host, Paul Sotomayor, and Plum the Mexican Vine Filipino Giant. What did I just try to say? Zaijian means goodbye in Chinese. Malasalam that means goodbye in Arabic. Farvel that means goodbye in Danish. Auf Wiedersehen that means goodbye in German. In my language, of course. Goodbye.